U.S. basketball star Brittany Griner sentenced to 9.5 years in prison by a Russian court. Griner was found guilty of smuggling and possessing a significant amount of narcotics. The 31-year-old was arrested in February after she was found carrying vape cartridges with cannabis oil in her luggage. Now, U.S. President Joe Biden has released a statement calling the sentence unacceptable. He also reiterated that he would explore every avenue to repatriate Griner. Griner's trial accelerated in recent days as Washington and Moscow discussed a potential prisoner swap. The House urging Moscow to accept what it calls a substantial offer to bring Griner and other American prisoners home. There is no official confirmation on who Washington has offered. Now, the highest profile Russian prisoner in the U.S. is an arms trafficker dubbed the Merchant of Death, who is serving 25 years in jail.
Ukraine says it has repelled new attempts by Russia to advance in an eastern strategic stronghold. The Ukrainian military claims to have stopped at least two Russian assaults on the fortified village of Pisky. But the Russian Defense Ministry says they had inflicted heavy losses on Ukrainian forces in other parts of the Donetsk province. The chief of the NATO military alliance says Russia and its aggressive policy must not succeed. He made that remark as a majority of NATO's member states ratified their requests by Finland and Sweden to join the alliance. Russia shares a land border with Finland and has warned its neighbor against joining NATO.
Japan calls for an immediate stop to China's military drills around Taiwan. Beijing has fired missiles near Taipei as part of huge military drills sparked by U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit to the self-ruled island. Tokyo says five ballistic missiles launched by China fell into Japan's exclusive economic zone, prompting it to lodge a diplomatic protest. Pelosi has since arrived in Japan, the last stop of her Asia tour. The United States also urging China not to overreact to Pelosi's Taiwan trip. The spokesperson of the U.S. National Security Council said there is no reason why a manufactured crisis should exist.
We do not believe it is in our interest, Taiwan's interest, the region's interest, to allow tensions to escalate further, which is why a long-planned Minuteman III ICBM test scheduled for this week has been rescheduled for the near future. As China engages in destabilizing military exercises around Taiwan, the United States is demonstrating instead the behavior of a responsible nuclear power by reducing the risks of miscalculation and misperception.
China's military drills are scheduled to last until Sunday. The maneuvers are taking place along some of the world's busiest shipping routes. Now, warnings have been issued to ships to avoid the areas being used for the exercises. Taiwan says 18 international flight routes have also been disrupted.
The Association of Southeast Asian Nations also calling for maximum restraint. ASEAN foreign ministers warn rising tensions in the Taiwan Strait could lead to miscalculation, open conflicts, and unpredictable consequences among major powers. They stress the regional bloc stands ready to play a constructive role in facilitating peaceful dialogue between all parties. The statement comes as ministers gather for meetings in Cambodia this week. As for Taiwan, it says it's now preparing for a possible conflict. Taipei's defense ministry says the military is closely monitoring unprecedented Chinese drills taking place in waters surrounding the island. But it asserts it will never seek war.
China's military drills around Taiwan come as the world's largest maritime exercise to help promote a free and open Indo-Pacific concludes. U.S. Navy Vice Admiral Michael Boyle, commander of the Rim of the Pacific, underscores the importance of the exercise amid current tensions in East Asia. More than 20 countries, including the Philippines, sent ships, personnel, and equipment to train in and around the Hawaiian Islands and Southern California.
By coming together, I do believe it's a deterrent to anyone who would try to.
The Philippines expressing concern as well over the rising tensions in the Taiwan Strait. In a statement, the Foreign Affairs Department urged all parties to exercise restraint. It also reiterated the Philippines will adhere to the One China policy. National Security Advisor Clarita Carlos also saying the Philippines will stay neutral on the issue since China and the U.S. are both allies.
We will just continue engaging with both parties, with both actors. And the president has declared that repeatedly that we will engage critically and constructively with both China and the U.S.
Carlos hopes the U.S.-China conflict will not be the only issue that will be discussed in the upcoming visit of U.S. State Secretary Antony Blinken to the Philippines. Blinken will meet President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. this weekend.
Dami naman nilang levels of cooperation dapat eh. Climate change, protection of the environment, maritime security, ang dami-daming levels talaga ng cooperation na pwede nilang gampanan, no? So, bakit yung conflict ang nagiging, ang nananaig?
Flag carrier Philippine Airlines closely monitoring the situation in Taiwan after it issued an airspace closure notice. China escalated its military activities in areas near Taiwan following the visit of U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. The airspace closure notice was set from 12 noon of August 4 until August 7. But PAL says a flight set today will proceed as scheduled and they will carry out a rerouting. The carrier is coordinating with Taiwan's aviation authorities as it avoids restricted airspace.